Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with our look at today's stock market. It's coming up to 7 a.m. on the East Coast, and stock index futures are flat to slightly negative. Commodity futures are down. Gold's down $10. Crude oil's down $1. So looking for some continued weakness in the Canadian stock market on Wednesday. Nothing new to report today. Bond prices continue to move higher, whether you're looking at the futures contract or U.S. bonds, Canadian bonds. They continue to move higher. No change in the currency market. U.S. dollar still on a buy signal here. Euro still on a sell signal. Continued weakness for the British pound, a little strength for the Japanese yen, and continued weakness for the Canadian dollar. Looking at the VIX had an inside day yesterday, so we're still looking for a breakdown below the lower channel line, so a close below 1646 would be needed to get me bullish on the overall stock market. For the NASDAQ, we're looking for the VIX to come down below 1864. Again, an inside day for the VIX for the NASDAQ on Tuesday. There's the global Dow making a lower low yesterday. The Dow 30 made a lower low. There's the TSX continuing to move lower. Now, it had some catching up to do as the Canadian market was closed on Monday. S&P 500 lower low yesterday. NASDAQ 100 a lower low. Now, we did see a bid into small and mid-cap U.S. stocks yesterday. We saw the Russell move higher yesterday. A lot of people got excited about that, but we're still trading below the lower channel line. That is also true for the ZAX microcap. So I would love small and mid-cap stocks to lead the market higher, but that's not what it's doing. Yesterday was a one-day move. If we get continuation for a couple of days, hey, we might have something. But yesterday was just a one-day move. It certainly did get a lot of people's attention. There's the Venture Exchange continuing to make a lower low. Yesterday, bank stocks closed a little higher on the day in the U.S., but made a lower low yesterday. There's Canadian bank stocks, of course, playing catch-up. Breaking down below the earlier lows from a couple of weeks ago. We've got credit card stocks making a lower low yesterday. There's U.S. energy stocks continuing to move lower. Canadian energy stocks continuing to move lower. Gold stocks, fairly quiet trading yesterday. Almost an inside day for the XAU, still trading in the channel. The TSX gold index traded up through the upper channel line there, but still on a sell signal, unfortunately. Gold's down. Last time I checked, about $10 in the pre-market this morning. Semiconductors were up yesterday. Still, we've got a big open gap there to get through on the way back up. So that is going to be quite a concern on the way up. But so far, we're not getting anywhere near testing that. Transports were up nicely yesterday, led by airline stocks and the trucking sector. Both of those, no change in trend. The trucks traded up to the lower channel line, but did not close above it. So still in a downtrend, no change there. Looking at commodity prices, the commodity tracking ETF continued to move lower yesterday. Copper continued to move higher. Gold was up yesterday. It's down in the pre-market this morning. We hit our first target at 118.75. 121.88 is our next target to the upside. I would certainly be a lot more confident about gold if platinum and silver were playing and going in the same direction, but unfortunately they're not. Platinum, we're looking for a close above 124.22 to give us a buy signal on Wednesday, and 1675 for silver. Since those two are not moving in the same direction as gold, I'm not that confident that gold is going to be able to continue higher from here. Looking at price targets for silver, 1719 is our first price target, but we're going to be pretty close to that when we get a buy signal. So look two lines up. 1875 would be my target to the upside with a stop at 1797 or $18, but we don't have a buy signal just yet for silver, so we may be looking at retesting the recent low before we can go higher. Looking at the energy sector, and you know this story, crude oil continued to move sharply lower yesterday. So I'd imagine the crude oil futures contract is probably going to head down and test 75. There's gasoline continuing to move lower. We have one car that takes premium gas, and so this is a really good thing for that little car. Looking at natural gas, we were down yesterday. Still nothing going on in the natural gas sector. Let's finish off this morning's presentation with a quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. There's the VIX, still, of course, above the flypaper channel. For anything major to change in the stock market, we need the VIX to start trading below the flypaper channel. The first sign that something new is happening on Wednesday is going to be an hourly close below 21.89 for the VIX for the S&P 500 cash index. There's the S&P 500 holding support at 1875. 1859.38, 1843.75 are the next targets to the downside. On the upside, you can see the moving averages are all pointing lower. We found resistance at the 200-hour moving average. Then we started to break down, made a lower low, resistance at the 100-hour moving average. And now the first target should be the 50-hour moving average, which is coming in at 1920. We're still projecting lower prices here, so not too concerned about that on Wednesday morning. The first sign that something new is happening on Wednesday is going to be an hourly close above 1896.71, 3856.19 on the NASDAQ 100. Quick look at the XAU. It's stuck at the 100-hour moving average at the moment. If we could break out above the 200-hour moving average, then I think you'd see the majority of gold-related stocks on buy signals, but we're not seeing that at the moment, and currently projecting prices to continue sideways. The TSX has been clustering around the 14,062.50 level. If we take out the recent low, look for move down to 13,750 on the hourly charts, which is also the next target on the daily chart. So 13,750 is our next target. For things to turn around on Wednesday, we need an hourly close above 14,209 to give us a new intraday buy signal on Wednesday. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Just looking over my shoulder, the futures haven't changed. U.S. stock index futures flat, European futures down across the board. We've got commodities still lower in the pre-market, gold down $10, crude oil down a dollar. So looking for a quieter open in the U.S. while we're going to see continued weakness in the Canadian stock market. I'll be back in a little while looking at the New York Stock Exchange 10 most actively traded stocks, and back tomorrow morning looking at the 10 most actively traded stocks on the TSX. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again soon.